What's up guys, welcome back to another Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Duel video, Monarchs with Brandish. There's actually some nice synergy with both decks. It's not completely on the same power level as good old school 2016 structure deck Monarchs, but well, it's just like a different deck, using the extra deck a little more as, you know, a toolbox slash engine. Of course, the Brandish cards, you know, they have like a searcher, which also nets you like an upstart goblin if you have like three, well, from the start, if you have like three or more spells in your graveyard. Then the token generator is also quite crucial, again, giving you, first of all, a monster that's being able to be tributed. It's like also a plus one upon summon, right? It can potentially search something into the end phase. It can be protection. You know, there, again, synergy with Brandish and Monarchs. The field spell also triggers when popped or destroyed by Kures, and again, special summoning Ray, the level 3 from the deck. Ray also very nice, can be tributed, is a warrior type, can be needed for going for the Normal Knight Link monster, you know, the Normal Knight Link, sending one equipped from your deck to the graveyard. Autonomous action unit for that particular reason is here in the main deck, but again, other options like the Monarch themed equip spell is an option. The Brandish equip spell is also an option, but the biggest weakness of Brandish is that you can't control, you know, a regular monster in your main monster zone. So that's something to keep in mind, and that's why I still prefer Autonomous Action Unit. Again, a very versatile card. It also helps going for Skeldeed. As for the rest, they also, what is it called, the Widow Anchor or something like that? Brandish Brain Control, pretty much. The one of Spell Destroyer for Brandish is also in the main deck, just being searchable off of your Brandish search and, you know, potentially destroying a set spell from your opponent's spell or trap. And again, if you have like three or more spells, destroying a monster on the field as well. Again, searchable one-off should be fine. Consistency can be an issue. Triple Terraforming again, giving you some more consistency of getting those three spells needed in your graveyard. So again, let's see a couple of example duels. Okay, I have a couple of examples ready. First of all, again, there is some nice synergy between both, you know, card series, both the Brandish and the Monarchs, of course. But again, one of the biggest weaknesses of this deck is that you have to open like a tribute monster. Kuros is fine. Erebus, of course, Aether is fine. There is also like the one-off decked, what's it called, the Diablos in the main deck. Worst case scenario, he can, of course, can also be used as a tribute monster, but that's something you'd definitely, well, rather not want to do, right? But it can potentially be triggered to the field when you like tribute a dark monster, right? It's your dark squire, or yeah, your dark Vazal, for example. You know, possible. Yeah, you know, Erebus being tributed for there are tons of examples, right? Ray also has that tribute effect. That's definitely a good field, so definitely going to search out the, what is it called? I forgot its name. It's a continuous spell. It's like pretty much a spellbook of judgment for the archetype. Popping my own field spell, but first popped one of his monsters and one of his set spells or traps. That leaves a field wide open again, and then, you know, keep upgrading your stuff. Thanks to the three or more spells in my graveyard, I can use the both the effects of the Brandish spells, get more searches, use the Brain Control eventually, put me in a very good position, and I believe the Erebus sniped one of the tour guides away. Also, one of the weaknesses of this deck is you're running out of Monarch spell and traps quite easily, quite fast, and the trap card... The Monarch Trap card is only at 2 in the main deck. As you saw, 41 cards in the main deck, that's a bit iffy. 41 is fine even with Upstart. Again, Upstart is needed. You know, it's like just an extra spell, an easy spell to get in the graveyard. Same for Terraforming. So again, the deck still needs work, but all suggestions are welcome. Keep in mind, again, return on the field, you can't special summon from the extra deck, but this deck has some built-in distraction effects. You know, Kuras, for example, the field spell, the Brandish field spell also has like a built-in distraction effect of any card you control. Well, if you excavate like the top three cards, and one of them being like a Brandish card, their spellbook of judgment, their continuous spell also has a a distraction effect. So again, you can potentially destroy your only monster in your main monster zones to make use of your Brandish spells and traps. Get the Spellbook of Judgment again, the Brandish Spellbook of Judgment live again, that will get some nice pluses in the end phase. Normal Knight Link monster again, the same as I believe a couple of weeks/months ago, using like again special summoning the idea, special summon Eidos, get the extra tribute summon for the turn. You can't go for the extra summon after that, but again, just keep that in mind, right? The one of Diablos in the main deck, I was running like multiples earlier, but again, just testing. It's a tech card, can be searched, or at least, yeah, it can be sent from your deck to the graveyard with Foolish Burial next to, of course, your idea or Erebus. But if you hard draw it, it's not that that terrible. Again, it can just be like free, like an easy beat stick. You know, it's affected, it cannot be targeted by your opponent's card effects. It also has like a like a Forceful Sentry effect. Again, quite good. Can easily be special summoned if you tribute Erebus, for example, or Eidos. So there is again synergy, but not really sure if I want to still main deck one copy. And again, possibly just like a nice tech card. Another example, again, going first. Yeah, I've left out the couple of examples, at least a couple of replays I've had with this particular deck. You know, the going first is, of course, the ideal situation. You know, in today's format, a lot of hand traps. You can play around that, or, well, it's not too devastating. Same for Ash Blossom, Ghost Ogre as well. But, well, yeah, you know what I mean, right? You'd rather not want your opponent having like a hand trap, but that's pretty much with every deck, right? Then again, the impact of a possible hand trap from the opponent is much bigger. Let's say for like a fragile deck compared to something like super consistent like Pendulum Magicians. I'm not really sure why I used Monster Reborn, but again, to each their own. Use Autonomous Action Unit, again, get the fourth monster on the field to go for Skeldeed. The times of using Skeldeed in Monarchs, again, getting four draws, but again, this is one of the biggest weaknesses of the deck, not drawing into any tributes, even after Skeldeed. If the opponent didn't have the Ghost Ogre, well, no, it's not going to matter too much. Again, no tribute monster. Him not having the Ghost Ogre would lead to like a Skeldeed into Special Summon Idea, go for Eidos, and, you know, potentially giving me an extra tribute summon, but nope, doesn't really matter. So that's something I'm still working on, you know, more tributes. Vanity's Fiend, you know, being super ignorant is definitely an option. Just slap in three Vanity's Fiend in the main deck. It's like, it can definitely be like a one card win condition against a lot of decks. So even if you brick, you can just drop Vanity's Fiend and be very ignorant. But yeah, it's not going to matter too much. No return because of the ABC Dragon Buster, just, you know, banishing the Erebus and leaving the return dead on the field. But now I can potentially draw into Aether, which is, you know, my only out here. But nope, no Aether, so that's GG, well played. Again, the first turn, the first and second turn, not drawing into a tribute monster was super crucial. Anyway, same opening, searching the Spellbook of Judgment for Brandish and keep using those searches. Again, get potentially, or hoping to get those three spells in the graveyard to get the extra draw effect of the Brandish Searcher. Not that hard for this deck. Again, Tenacity, Pantheism, potentially getting an extra spell in the graveyard, Terraformings as well. You can work towards your, your engine and your pluses. Try to use the field spell popping, at least try to pop the Erebus to get, not really a plus, but something, you know, one of the excavated cards back to my hand. Here I think I was active, at least playing a little bit too quickly. Anyway, use Wave to blow away one of his back rows, also the monster. But again, go for Erebus, get rid of like his only in-hand card, I believe. Set up the Pantheism, I believe. No, Pantheism was already used, but definitely the Prime Monarch. Keep Autonomous Action Unit in my hand. Again, that can lead to a potential Skeldeed play, drawing into a potential tribute monster, an extra potential tribute monster, right? Using the field spell, popping the Prime, I believe. I'm somewhat lucky, I guess. Not really that important, not really sure. I think I have an Erebus in my graveyard, but yep, no Monarch spell and trap, so okay, that's all good. Doesn't really matter too much. Get a search here in the that's so good, right? It feels like Zodiacs. You can just keep special summoning your Link monsters and using some more shenanigans. He does scoop it up. A bit sad again. I could have used Skeldeed to special summon the Eidos from the hand. Go for the tribute summon. Well, yeah, first use the Brain Control, the Brandish Brain Control, then go for Skeldeed, etc., etc. But again, the synergy is quite clear, but as I mentioned before, this well, Brandish Monarchs is not really on the same level as, you know, good old extra deck Monarchs or Domain Monarchs from a couple of years ago, for the most obvious reasons. But again, it's quite good. The engine, the Brandish engine, serves like a draw engine, semi-draw engine, gives you Tribute Father. Again, quite good, right? Okay, Domain on the field, not really sure why he's using the Harmonizing as a skill. Anyway, to each their own. He's going for Electromites and again, Astrograph Sorcerer, eventually going for Decor Dark and Vortex as well, but again, that's not really threatening. I think he knows that I have the Stormfort. He definitely knows that I have like the Brandish Brain Control. This is what that's what I like here. The Spellbook of Judgment also triggers during your opponent's turn. When you know, activate like multiple Brandish spells, you can just during that particular end phase set like the same amount back to your side of the field from your graveyard, that is. So the token generator card is so good. In getting the Brandish Link that gets something back from my graveyard, luring out the Vortex and the Deco Talker. Not really sure, I don't think I can go for a game, but my plan here was again just to go for Aether Erebus. Well, Aether Stormfort, that is, getting the Stormfort back from the Banished Pile with Idea, and of course the Aether Surge off of return, and you know, pretty much seal the deal next turn. Deal some damage, and again, full control of the duel, getting more pluses out of the Spellbook of Judgment, and nope, that monster on Purple Poison? Yeah, Purple Poison Magician is definitely not enough. So, final conclusion about the deck, I like this deck. It's not, well, you have to keep track, you know, of the restrictions. The main monster zone, monsters in the main monster zone with the Brandish cards, return being phase up, right, not being able to special summon from the extra deck, those kind of restrictions, it's very easy to forget, right? But again, like always, all suggestions are welcome, and yeah, just feel free to leave suggestions. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks so much, and feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. Leetum signing out. Peace.